next instalment of the Golden Intruder. This is our first week, and we've just been to a Christian Science church. So what were your first impressions of the church, Ian?
My first impressions were that it was a little bit dull. It was like a trainee carpenter had his way with the hall.
What about you? It was very much like an old Anglican kind of church. It was just your standard brick, stained glass. The pews had cushions, but apart from that, no real embellishments. All old ladies.
Yeah, all lovely old ladies. We got approached by nice old ladies, and they were just lovely. The service was particularly traditional.
Very traditional.
It just contained teachings and readings, and then some nice Nintendo sing-alongs.
So a bit of background on the church. What we read on the net before we went was Christian Science was started by a lady called Mary Baker Eddy. She was a Christian. She was in the sort of 19th century. She actually got sick in the 1866. She got sick and she actually meditated on the Bible, and she kind of reinterpreted it. She decided that that the only real truth was the spiritual realm. So what God has made in the spiritual realm is the only real truth. And what we experience as the material, material physical world is more of an illusion. So therefore, any sickness is not really a reflection of the spiritual truth.
Well, actually, they talked about cerebral palsy, and they said that if you think it's not real and you believe that it's not real, your muscles will actually forget. It's all in the mind. So I'm sure the Cerebral Palsy Society would have something to say about that.
They probably would. So we actually had the pleasure of talking with some of these old ladies afterwards. They were very good about answering all my questions. They pretty much had a go at everything we threw at them. What did you start talking about?
I just wanted to know about their personal beliefs and why they actually chose Christian Science. And a couple of them did come from a mainstream Christian background, but they converted because they'd normally experienced some sort of hardship or some sort of illness that they overcome with Christian Science.
One lady actually, she had a healthy life, and she actually used that as evidence of the truth of the belief, because had she not been a devout Christian Scientist, she may have been sick. You could tell that this book that Mary Baker Eddy had written, we've got a copy of that book. Mary Baker Eddy's Science and Health with Key to the Scriptures. She published after she got better. She published in 1875. And what it basically does is goes through and you look at the Bible, and then this bit is like a commentary of the Bible. I remember in the service they told the story of Jesus and the centurion who said to Jesus, "Look, I understand that you've got authority, and you don't have to come and put your hands on my son, you can just heal him by saying the word." And then we read the corresponding thing in the Christian Science book, and it was bizarre. Music-wise, they had the Nintendo organ, but then they had a lady who got up and did a bit of a singing solo. She actually then fell asleep during the service in front of everybody. We thought she might have been falling into a meditative state, but when we saw how glazed her expression was when she finally woke up, she was definitely just
having a bit of a snooze.
Good old-fashioned kid.
Yeah, and, as did the woman next to me. She was wake, startling herself up.
Yeah.
So, maybe Christian Science isn't for us if you want to stay awake.
Not at all. And it's too relaxing.
Yeah, maybe someone that they were mainly there to cure narcolepsy.
Which hadn't worked very well.
Maybe they don't understand it on a spiritual level yet.
Yeah. Some of the other conversation highlights. We spoke to one lady for quite a while who, she was the lady who had never been sick, so that was why she believed. She spoke about her mother who had a tapeworm infection.
The tapeworm. That would have been gross.
She kept getting reinfected by this tapeworm, and through Christian Science, it was able to remove the tapeworm. And that was one of the questions I had, was on the material domain, what actually happens to the sickness? Does the tapeworm vanish, or does it, what happens to it? And she basically said, you know, out the poo hole, like the normal method.
Yeah, apparently you can cure cancer.
You can cure cancer.
That easy. Not, you know, the cancer thing's a big issue in the Christian community.
Yep.
But you just have to believe it's not real. So if you've got cancer, think it's not real and it'll go away. I'm sure that you'll be enlightened anyway. So towards the end, James needed to pass wind in the service, and considering how quiet it was in there,
I did feel a considerable discomfort in my.
Was it God speaking through you?
No, I think it was my breakfast speaking to me.
Pancakes.
Yeah.
Pancakes.
And I pondered in my head whether perhaps this is the only place that you could really get away with doing such a thing, because from what I understood from the sermon, that farts are only an illusion.
So where are we up to next week?
Next week we're up to the Christian City Church Victory. What are we hoping?
Tongues.
Speaking in tongues. We want a lot of arm waving. We want
a lot of singing. So until next week, goodbye.